गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग पार्ट्स ऑफ चैप्टर 3, दैट इज द फ्लावर एंड द पेज नंबर 39-40 वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड ऑल दीज पार्ट्स ऑफ फ्लावर थ्रू डायग्राम. सो नाउ हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ऑल दीज पार्ट्स वन बाई वन. एंड द फर्स्ट वन इज कैलिक्स. कैलिक्स इज द आउटर मोस्ट होल. दिस वन इज द कैलिक्स. This one is the calyx, this one is corolla, this one is androecium, and this one is gynoecium. So the unit of calyx is sepal. Now these are generally green in color and presents 3 or 4 in numbers, but the colors of calyx may be colored, and whenever the color of calyx is colored, then that type of sepal is known as petaloid sepal, as for example in gulmohar. So sepals are also of two types, polysepals and gamosepals. Okay, poly, that means free. Here the sepals are free, as for example rose. And the gamosepals, that means gamo word used for fused. So the sepals are fused in the condition of gamosepals, as for example China rose. The main function of the sepal is to protect the other holes of the flower in bud condition. I repeat once again, the floral holes. This one is the first. This one first, this one second, this one third, and this one gynoecium is the fourth hole of the flower. Now, the function, it encloses and protects the inner holes, and it can also do the photosynthesis, and it attracts insects and birds for pollination. Now, the second hole, that is corolla. This one is the second hole from outside. Generally, this one is white or brightly colored, but it may be green color, and whenever the petals are green in color, then that type of petal are known as sepaloid petals. The unit of corolla is petal. The unit of corolla is petal, and this petal is larger than sepal. Now the function of sepal. Now this petal also categorized into two, poly and gamo, because these petals are also found in 3 or 5 in number. So the petals may be free, and that condition is known as polypetalous, as for example mustard. And the petals may be fused, and that condition is known as gamopetalous. But in case of petal and gamopetalous, it may be partially fused and it may be completely fused. The partially fused, the example of partially fused is petunia, and the completely fused, whenever the petals are completely fused, they form a tube-like structure, and this tube is known as corolla tube. Now the function of petals, it attract insects for pollination. They have nectar cells at the base, and they encloses reproductive part of a flower like androecium and gynoecium. Now the third one hole from outside is the androecium. This one is also known as the male reproductive part. So this one is male reproductive part. Now we are going to here discuss about the androecium. So this one is the structure of androecium, and the unit of androecium is known as stamen. This one is stamen, and stamen consists of two parts, the anther and the filament. And the two anther, because the stamen is consist of two anther. This one is a structure of two lobed, and the lobes are attached with each other by a connective. Now in each lobe there are two pollen sac. In each lobe there are two pollen sac. So whenever we talk about an stamen and anther, there are four pollen sac within pollen grains are present. So within the anther, the pollen grains are produced, and pollen grain contain the male reproductive part. Within the anther, the pollen grains are present, and pollen grain contain the male gametes. Is that the gametes? And the filament, the function of filament, that bear and support the anther in the most suitable position for pollination. So this all about androecium. Now next one, we have to study about the variation in the androecium. So androecium, when we talk about the variation in the androecium, in later section of our class. So variation we discussed in our later section of class.